Hi everyone, thanks for joining me today. My name is Justin Luong. I'm a PhD candidate at the University of California, Santa Cruz, and thanks for joining my lightning talk at the 11th Northern California Botanist Symposium titled Management and Ecological Surveys Indicate Long-Term Grassland Restoration Success, the Potential for Biotic Homogenization. Grasslands make up a large extent of California. Coastal California grasslands are thought to be unique grasslands because they receive summertime fog and are also thought to be the most diverse grassland type of all North America. Grasslands, however, are rapidly changing because of land use change and often are directly displaced or sometimes indirectly affected by habitat fragmentation, although they're important for biodiversity. Ecological restoration is the act of helping to recover a lost or degraded ecosystem, oftentimes through human interventions such as outplanting native species or control of invasive species. Oftentimes, because restoration is a human intervention, motivations can greatly vary by practitioner and across agencies. On top of that, restoration outcomes are relatively unknown because there's often a lack of funding to resurvey projects after they've been implemented. And even though restoration has been occurring and been documented strongly since the 1980s, restoration projects often aren't assessed after 5 years or assessed multiple times. Therefore, we don't really know what's happening with restoration projects in the long term. To better understand the long and midterm outcomes of coastal California restoration projects, I surveyed 36 projects across a 1,000 kilometer span from Santa Barbara County to Humboldt County, California. I surveyed a total of 32 sites my first year and then resurveyed several of those sites in subsequent years. In 2021, I identified 5 new sites from management interviews and also surveyed those. Sites that I surveyed were at least 3 years post-planting or seeding, at least 1 acre in size, and received summertime coastal fog. By 2021, all of the sites I surveyed ranged from 5 to 32 years in age. I also conducted project document analyses and interviewed practitioners from all restoration projects to determine the original project-based goals. We found that all but one project reached their project-based goals. And then we found that 81% of projects also were successful at reaching a standard performance metric of 25% native cover and 6 native species after 5 years. 6% of projects fell within 5% range and 13% of projects needed improvement. Previously, practitioners thought that we may be losing native cover over time. However, our results find that native cover did not decrease or was not related to post-implementation age. We did find, however, that non-native species cover was weakly and positively correlated with project age, increasing as post-implementation age increased. Furthermore, we found that non-native competition strongly impacts restoration efforts, as increased non-native cover was associated with decreased native cover in native species richness. Interestingly, management interviews indicate that 88% of restoration projects are using the same 8 species across this 1,000 kilometer range because they believe they will grow faster or survive better to reach project goals. However, these species are all perennial species and may be contributing to what we call the perennialization of California grasslands, where annual species, which are harder to restore, are not used and may eventually be lost, resulting in regional biotic homogenization or regional diversity loss. We find that although California coastal grassland restoration is largely successful at reaching both project-based goals and a standard performance metric, invasive species is still a huge issue within restoration. We also find that practitioners are preferentially using the same species across this 1,000 kilometer range due to risk aversion and the desire to achieve project goals. However, this may lead to potential diversity reductions in the future if coordination of species for restoration is not completed across a greater regional scale. Thanks everyone again for joining my talk. I'm happy to take questions live or on my email or Twitter, and please enjoy the rest of your symposium experience.